Continuous stirred tank reactors can have multiple steady state solutions to the mass and energy balances that describe the reactions in these stirred tank reactors. Here we're going to look at a reversible reaction, first order in each direction, and look at the effect of changing the value of the pre-exponential factor of the rate constant, K2, the feed temperature, and the heat transfer coefficient. So I've represented this process. It's at steady state, but depending on how we start the reactor, we can end up with different steady states. And in the table are listed the various parameters that are used for this model. So the first thing we're going to do is write down the mass balance for reactant A. It's at steady state, and we have a volumetric flow rate in with a concentration CA0. So this is the molar flow rate in. This is the molar flow rate out. And the difference is due to the reaction. So the reaction in a forward direction and then the reaction in the reverse direction. And likewise, we'll write down the energy balance where the volume times the density is the mass flow rate and a mass heat capacity. T minus T0, the term that corresponds to energy. If the feed is colder than the reactor temperature, energy to heat up the feed. And now the heat reaction per mole times the molar flow rate leaving the reactor of the product. So the concentration B at the exit times the volumetric flow rate is the molar flow rate. And then the term for heat transfer coefficient and heat transfer area and reactor temperature minus this cooling temperature. So these are two equations, and what I'm going to do is rearrange them. I'm going to use tau in the equations when I rearrange it, and rearrange them so I can plot concentration of B versus temperature. I'll make two plots, one for the mass balance and one for the energy balance. So here are the two equations, the mass balance, which you notice is nonlinear in temperature, and then the energy balance, which is linear in temperature. Look at these two equations on graph. The intersections then would be solutions that correspond to steady state solutions. And look at how they depend on these three parameters that we mentioned. So what I'm showing here is the Mathematica program that I use to generate plots of concentration of the product B as a function of the reactor temperature, and basically generated a plot for the energy balance and a plot for the mass balance, and then use this manipulate campaign, which explained in other screencasts, to generate the plot. We have the option of changing the values of three variables in this case. So what I'm showing here is the linear plot is the energy balance, and the nonlinear plot, the purple graph, is the mass balance. Where these two curves intersect correspond to steady state solutions of the mass and energy balance for the CSTR. And in the current condition, that's essentially zero conversion, no concentration product, and at the feed temperature. I can look at varying the feed temperature. So if I move this slider and increase the feed temperature, you notice I'll get to the point where I have more than one intersection. And so for a feed temperature of 266, I have three intersections. The upper and lower temperatures correspond to steady state solutions. The middle one corresponds to an unsteady state solution. Whether we're operating at the upper or lower one depends on how we start the reactor. But increasing the temperature of the feed enough will be in the one solution regime, where only the high conversion and the high temperature are possible. Now I'll move back to lower feed temperature. I can change the heat transfer coefficient. Currently, the heat transfer coefficient is zero, but if I increase it, notice I'm changing both the slope and the intercept of this energy balance line, and I can change this enough So for example, for this feed temperature, I have only one solution. If for a higher feed temperature, I have one solution also. And here, decrease the heat transfer coefficient, I can go back to possibility three solutions. The other variable is the pre-exponential factor for the reverse reaction. So this increases the rate constant for the reverse reaction. And notice what this changes is the mass balance curve. The maximum conversion is decreased. And indeed, here we have the possibility of one solution versus three solutions, depending on how reversible a particular reaction is. So we can look at, using this manipulate command in Mathematica, how the steady state solutions depend on these three variables.